Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about power system fault detection and classification using deep neural network. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. So power system fault detection and classification is a major role in the power system in order to safeguard the power system equipments. So in this video you have to see how to detect the fault and how to classify the fault by using neural network by implementing concept in the MATLAB. So straight away go to the MATLAB implementation. This is a model so created for a fault detection and the classification. Okay. So this model consists of 11 kilovolt 30 MVA source feeder, okay, and then step down transformer. The 11 kilovolt will be step down to 0.4 kilovolt, that means consumer and voltage level 400 volt, and then is connected with the load, okay, load feeder, and then step down transformer. And then here you can see that in a 11 kilovolt bus we are creating fault, okay, and also you have to measure the RMS value for each phase voltage, each phase, and then RMS current for the each line, okay. So and also I'm going to measure the zero sequence voltage and the zero sequence current for that 11 kilovolt bus. So this going to be taken as the data for input data for the neural network, and then we need to assign the target value for the neural network with some value. Okay. So this is system we are taking for fault detection and classification. So here line fault model, that means you can click here. So here we are not creating any fault, so this model will be considered as a normal working model. So here we are going to measure that RMS voltage, RMS current, and zero sequence current voltage, and then data going to be stored in the workspace. Okay, so this will be going to be stored in the workspace for collection of data for neural network, because the neural network need input output data for training. So we need to collect the data for normal operating condition and also collect the data under fault condition. Okay. And also we create a different fault model. Okay, here same model, but here we have created model that means the line to line fault between A and B. Okay, the same way we have created different fault model. Here you can see that triple line fault, ABC fault, right? And then you can click this one. So here you can see that triple end ground fault. For different fault we have created model. So each model we have to collect the data. Here you can see that double end ground fault, then line to line and ground, double end ground fault is created here, right? And then you can see that here So this is for a line to ground fault. Okay. So for all kind of fault created and stored in the different model, right? So after executing this each model, so we can collect the data. So here we are going to collect the data. Already I told, right? That mean we are going to collect RMS voltage, RMS current, zero sequence voltage and zero sequence current. Okay. So for each fault category, so you have to run the model and then collect the data. Okay. So for fault detection, okay. So the fault detection is going to be very based upon the fault resistance. So here we are going to consider three cases when the fault resistance equal to 0.1. And then fault resistance equal to 10 ohms, and then fault resistance is 100 ohms. So here we are considering three cases: case 1, case 2, and case 3. Okay. So for each case, we are going to simulate the model, normal working model, and then AG fault, PG fault is this, that means line to ground fault combination, and then double end to ground fault combination, and then triple end to ground fault, and then triple end fault, and then line to line fault. So each fault going to be simulated for the 0.4 seconds. Okay, so each condition, each scenario going to be simulated for the 0.4 seconds, and then from each scenario you have to collect the data. That may be A, B, 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 C, I, A, I, B, I, C, and V naught, I naught. So this is going to be stored in this some parameter X1. So this is going to be input for the neural network. And then for normal condition, right? So this is fault detection program. So for normal condition, the output parameter, the output data for that neural network is considered to be zero, because there is no fault, right? So that's why we are mentioning that value output will be target. So target equal to zero. But remaining cases for line to fault and double line to fault and double line fault, so you have to mention that the target will be one. So you have to identify the fault. Okay. After training process completed, okay, in the neural network supply output equal to zero, so that going to be considered there is no fault in the system. If neural network provide output equal to one, then it going to be considered as a system having fault. Okay, so this program only for that detecting the fault in the power system. Okay, if suppose I'm going to run this program, so each time it will be execute the all model and then collect the data. So you will see that the data details here. Okay, you can see that here. We will get the detail here. This window will get the detail. So after every model execution you will get input data and output data. So after completing that all simulation, so this is for collection of data. So here you can see that X data, right? So this is a collection of input data for me. Okay. So X data, it contains 360 cross 8 table. Okay, so this is a collection of data, input data, and then this is collection of output data. So it contains 360 cross 1 table. Okay, so this is going to be used for train the neural network. So X data, so input for that neural network, T data is input for the output for that neural network, input data and output target data. Okay, so this going to be used for train the neural network. So next process we are going to train the neural network. So here we will open that neural network fitting app, right? Next you have to click next button. Okay, after clicking next button, just you have to click these inputs. So here you need to provide input data. So here the X data is input data. Next you have to provide target data. So target data here is this data, T data, okay. After that click matrix rows. So after that click next button. And then here you will see that number of training, evaluation, testing data. So 70% is for training and 15% is for evaluation and testing. Next you go to click next button, and then next you go to receive the number of hidden neurons. So I'm going to take same hidden neurons, okay, 10 default value. Okay, I'm not going to change any value here. I'm going to click next, and then after that you have to train the neural network. So by clicking this train network. Okay, so the training process completed. So you will see that the training error here. So this is around 5.10⁻¹⁴. So it is nearer to zero, very very near to zero, mean squared error. So next you have to click that plot, regression plot. So you'll see that you will get R value equal to 1 for training, variation, test and overall process. So what's the meaning? Input output data is fitted with the trained data. So this is the meaning of the value of R equal to 1. So when R equal to 1, no need to worry about that. The neural network trained with our input output data. Okay, input and the target data. So next you have to click next button. After that click next. So this model going to be used in the simulating model, right? So just you have to click simulating diagram. And then save this diagram, okay, for later use. So I'm going to save this model as test 3, okay. So this will be used for this model, right? So this model going to be used for detecting the fault in this system. It would receive 8 inputs, right? 8 inputs, and then it will provide the single output, right? I'm going to simulate this one. It will provide some output, right? So based upon input we are giving here. Okay. So the fault detection neural network model is completed now. So next we concentrate on the fault classification system. Okay. So for fault classification system, same kind of model we are going to say, same kind of program we are going to use. As like in fault detection, except the target value, right? So here we are going to use this program for collecting the data for classification. So here I am going to create the output target value. Okay. So you can see that it contains, that means target contains 4 outputs, right? So it is normal operation, right? It is normal operation with contain the 4 outputs like 0, 0, 0, 0, right? So this form of binary, right? That means 4-bit binary number, okay? So for an A to ground fault, right? So I'm going to create the data equal to 1, 0, 0, 1. For B to ground, 0, 1, 0, 1. C to ground, 0, 0, 1, 1. For AB ground, 1101, for AC ground 1011, and then BC ground 0111, and then ABC ground is 1111, and then ABC fault, so out target is 1110. For AB is the target is 1100. For AC equal to 1010, for BC equal to 0110. Okay, So here I'm going to consider the binary form, 4-bit binary form, as a target output for a fault classification. So next process, you need to collect the data, collect the input data. So already we fixed that target, right? But we need to collect the input data also, right? So for that I'm going to simulate this model. So here you will see that collection of data for every model execution, right? So after completion of this program execution, so we will get X data, that means this is input data for neural network. This same that of that fault detection program, 360 cross 8, okay. And then output. So output consists of 360 cross 4, right? So this is the output target data, okay. So next process, we need to train the neural network. So once I go to neural network fitting app and then click next and then select the data, input data, and select the output data and click matrix rows and then click next. So this is for choosing number of training samples and testing samples and validation samples, okay. So here that 70% is in training and the remaining 15% and 15% for validation and testing. Okay. So next we need to choose the number of eaten neurons. So I'm going to use default value. So I'm going to click next. Okay. So after here we need to train the network. So just I'm going to click this train network. So here you can see that the mean squared error is around 0.2 × 10⁻². So next process, I'm going to click the plot progression and check the regression fault plot. Okay. So here you can see that the R value is nearer to 1, right? So it's around 0.97, here 0.98, so here 0.97, here 0.97. Okay. So almost that the trained neural network is matched with the our input and the target data. Okay, so the training process also okay. So click next and then save the simulink. Okay, so this is the simulink model for the fault classification. So here you can see that number of input will be 8 and then you will get 4 outputs here. So just I'm going to simulate this model, so you will get 4 outputs, right? Four outputs depending upon that this 8 inputs, right? So next I'm going to save this model. Okay, test 4, just you save this model for later use. Okay, so I will save this model, save that model. Okay, so next process, we need to create the fault detection classification model with the neural network. So for that I created same model here. Okay, the same system, the same above system. Okay, I explained earlier, right? 11 kilovolt 30 MVA source feeder with the step down transformer to step down the 11 kilovolt to 400 kilovolt for the consumer and usage, right? And then fault will be created here. Here you have to measure the RMS voltage and RMS current. So here I'm going to use that online fault detector model. So already is saved, right? That means fault detector neural network model. So here I use that neural network model here, and then fault classification neural network model I'm use here, right? So based upon fault, right, it will provide the logic here. So this is used for detecting the fault, and then this one used for classification of fault, right? So not to decode this logic. So here I generate some logic for decoding of the each fault, right? Fault detection, AG, PG fault, CG fault, line to ground fault for ABG, ACG, BCG, ABCG, AB, AC, BC and ABC. So here I'm going to create some R and one logic, okay, in order to classify the fault. Okay. So next time I'm going to give demo and classification. First time initially I'm not create any fault, right? System will be operate under normal operating condition. Okay. So we will check the response of this fault and fault reduction and fault classification. So now you can see that the fault detection is maintained at the zero. That means system under normal operating condition. And also you can check the different fault classification. So all value will be in zero, right? So system will be operate under normal operating condition. So next time I'm going to change the fault, right? Line to ground fault, AG. Okay. Next time I'm going to check the reduction. Okay. Yeah, fault will be occur after 0.1 second. Here we created AG fault. You can see that AG fault will be detected here, right? So next time I'm going to change BG fault. We will check the fault reduction and classification. So here also you can see that fault will be detected after 0.1 second. Fault PG fault also detected. Okay, so next time I'm going to change to CG fault. So here you can see that fault is detected here, CG fault also classified here. So next time I'm going to change to ABG fault, right? ABG fault. Yeah, so here fault is detected, and then finally we get the ABG fault also detected here. Okay, so next AGC fault. So fault is detected and ACG fault also classified, right? BCG fault. Fault is detected and BCG fault also classified. Okay. Next one is AB fault. Yeah. Fault is detected and AB fault also predicted, classified, right? And then AC fault. So fault is detected, AC fault also classified, and then BC fault. Fault is detected and BC fault also classified. So next one is ABC for fault. Here ABC fault is classified and fault also detected. Next one is ABC ground fault. ABC ground fault. Oh, fault is detected, but the classification is not fully classified. Okay, so instead of detecting ABCG ground fault, it detect only ABC fault, right? So totally there are 11 fault is created here. Out of 11 fault, a 10 fault is classified effectively. So that means the classification efficiency is around 90.9, that means 91%. So 91% having, that means 91% accuracy in the classification of fault in the system. So fault detection will be have 100% for all fault will be detected effectively, but during classification, this model not able to classify the ABCG ground fault effectively. Okay. So thank you for all. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for a notification about upcoming video. Thank you so much.